Emily, we'll check the flying sphere. I want to inspect the damage. I'll take Albert with me if you don't mind.
Oh my God! I need to save them!
Emily, stay calm. I'm sure they're all right. Please, think before you act.
They're gone. I have to do something to save them. There's no time to spare. Dad! Albert! Anyone! Please give me a sign!
You look desperate. What did you see? Talk to me, Emily!
The chasm's so deep and dark. I'm going to climb down there, but I need a rope.
That's not a good idea. You won't help them by falling down a hole. Try not to act too impulsively. You should check the crypt where the scientists were imprisoned. Look what I found. A scientist must have dropped it after leaving the crypt. Take it. You should check the crypt where the scientists were imprisoned. you should check the crypt where the scientists were imprisoned. Are you all right? I saw the rope slip. Please, don't try that again.
But Albert's down there, and my dad and everyone else as well. We must save them. You're right, though. It was stupid. I won't help them if I fall down there. Let me think. I saw an old book in the crypt. It talks about an underground labyrinth and a great chamber under the monastery.
An underground chamber? It probably collapsed, and the flying sphere fell down there.
Yes, I think so too. The entrance must be in the crypt. I just need to find it. Dad, can you hear me? Are you all right?
Yes, we're trapped in some kind of electromagnetic field. You need to deactivate the generators.
It could be dangerous to use those devices. We don't know what they do. Maybe I could use the Flying Sphere's radio control system to get you out of there.
Emily, please check those machines. I'm sure you can just turn the generators off. Emily, please check those machines. I'm sure you can just turn the generators off. Getting stronger. You were right. Try to use the radio control at our headquarters. Albert says you should set the radio control frequency to 7.5 megahertz before activating it. At that frequency, it should interfere with the electromagnetic field and neutralize it.
Oh, Emily, I've just checked the tower. The mounting for the bell ropes fell off. I think there's a secret compartment where bell ropes were tied.
I'll have a look. I found the flying sphere. Everyone is all right. But the sphere's trapped underground, and I have to use the radio control again.
Is something wrong with this device? I found a diagram of some kind. Maybe it'd help. It's on the green table where your dad and Albert were making their calculations.
Says you should set the radio control frequency to 7.5.
Coco, the radio control is on again. I'm going back underground.
All right, I'll stay here. Oh, what was that? I stepped on something. What's this? Some kind of comet badge? Here, take it.
Dad, I switched on the radio control. It isn't working, is it?
No, Emily, it isn't. So, there's only one option left. You need to carefully check the chamber again and find a way to deactivate the generators.
On fire. They burn alive. Dad, Albert.
Emily, I saw the flying sphere. It flew out of the sinkhole and landed somewhere near the river.
Emily, what happened? I heard you scream in the chamber and then you just ignored us.
I thought you were dead. The flying sphere seemed to disappear in flames, but it turns out it just became invisible.
We didn't notice anything change, beside your strange behavior. Oh, and that skeleton, of course. It has human proportions, but it's not human. I wonder where the skull is.
I think I know where it is, and I'm going to put it back.
Be careful. It must have been some kind of supernatural being. I'm sure the staff you've got belongs to him. Over there.
It's some kind of flying machine.
It's a spaceship. It must be going home.